on that Thursday.
You know, it's if he is confirmed, it's a big win for the Republicans. It's a big win for the President of the United States. And as David pointed out and others have pointed out, take a look at the jobs numbers that came out today, 3.7% unemployment in the month of September, the lowest since 1969, 49 years. And you know the president is gloating about that.
Yeah, I think he tweeted about that earlier today. This, if he gets on the bench, this is probably the most important week of his presidency in terms of what it means, in terms of what it means for the midterms, and also in terms of what it means for his legacy, right? If Kavanaugh gets on the bench, it's a culmination of a decades-long fight among Republicans to control the courts, and it'll matter for 30 or 40 years on many, many issues, abortion, voting rights, gerrymandering and redistricting, gun rights, the death penalty, all sorts of issues that are going to come before this court. Obamacare as well, that's going to be a big issue too. And, you know, at some point Donald Trump said, you know, folks are going to get sick of winning. This week, that might actually be true because there have been a lot of W's.
A lot of Democrats were just assuming there was going to be a blue wave in a few weeks in the midterm elections. But if this nomination is confirmed, another conservative is on the U.S. Supreme Court, not for 4 years or eight years, but maybe for 30 years. Yeah. It's a lifetime appointment, 35 years. That's a big political gain for the Republicans. And the economy, James Carville once said, it's the economy's stupid. The economy's in pretty good shape right now, and these numbers are very impressive.
There's no doubt about that. So for the bulk of the last year and a half, since Donald Trump has become president, if you look at politics in America, we've seen this supercharged enthusiasm on the Democratic side. We've seen it in special election after special election, turnout numbers across all the primary season. So we've seen Democrats so excited and enthusiastic to sort of deliver a report card to Donald Trump 2 years into his administration. Republicans, every Republican strategist I talked to for the last year and a half, really concerned about complacency among their voters, which is natural when you are in power. Now, if they get Kavanaugh on the court, this economy, this is a shot in the arm for Republicans to feel good about this. I'm not suggesting that all of a sudden a blue wave doesn't happen. I think this Kavanaugh episode has been terrible for Republicans in the House landscape that Nia was talking about, with white college-educated women, suburbanites, exactly where Republicans need to hang on to seats if they want to hang on to their House majority. But on the Senate map, Wolf, which so much of that is playing out in deep red states, getting that shot in the arm for Republicans, that keeps Josh Hawley in the hunt in Missouri. That keeps Mike Braun in the hunt in Indiana. That keeps Matt Rosendale in the hunt in Montana. So those Democratic incumbents in those deep red states, they would have loved to have no parity and enthusiasm. They're not loving to see that Republicans are now psyched about this good week that the president very well may be, you know, capping off tomorrow with a final vote.
And Joe Manchin's in a tough re-election race in West Virginia, as we know.